Are you dealing with cultural change within your organization and is proving to be much more challenging than you expected? Well, keep on watching. My name is Isabella Brusati and I am the founder of Isabella Brusati Consulting. We specialize in change management with particular focus on the people aspect of mergers and acquisitions. In my over 15 years career, I have noticed that lots of companies struggle when they are dealing with cultural change. The attitude is actually to brush the culture as something that should be delegated to HR or something that the executives shouldn't be involved in. Another justification is that culture cannot be measured and therefore is fluff. I do not agree with the myths that I have now outlined with regards to culture. First of all, because culture has got to be aligned with the strategy and therefore it falls under the remit of executives. It's the implementation that has to be carried out by other departments, for example, the change management office. But with regards to culture in itself, it's not fluff and actually can be measured. In this series of videos, I'm going to talk about culture and how it is possible to change it. There are several aspects that we have to be aware of in order to be successful when changing culture. If we just dismiss as fluff or something that cannot be measured, well, we will be always stalled. And it's actually quite funny because we want change to be implemented within an organization, but we don't want to change our own mentality. Well, it's not gonna work. So in this series of videos, I'm going to go through a simple model that was designed by Edgar Schein to explain what is culture, how culture works, and the reason why it is difficult but not impossible to change culture. First of all, I would like to start with pointing out that there are some elements that are very important for a company to be successful, things like just like I'm talking financially successful. So for example, if the company's got a dominant position and there are not that many competitors that are offering our products or services, well, of course, in this case, the market has got only one choice or we are one of the very few choices. This, of course, it puts us in a very favorable position. Also, if you are one of the very few companies that are offering a specific product, the consumers don't have a lot of choice. This means that we can keep the prices higher, but as the consumers don't have lots of choice, they will rely on us and they will depend on our company, you know, if they want to purchase a specific product or if they want a specific service. On the other side, the same thing with the suppliers. If they depend on us and there are not that many alternatives, well, of course, our revenues will be higher. Also, if there are high barriers to an entry, like for example a specific technology or proprietary knowledge, well, in this case financial success is, I'm not saying easier, but you know, there are conditions that clearly are going to help. Notwithstanding the conditions that we are just talking about are basically what Porter was highlighting as critical for success, well, there are plenty of companies that over the past 20-30 years have experienced a lot of financial success but were not operating in a market that was characterized by those financial conditions. Let's take Apple. Apple was on the verge of bankruptcy just in 1998, so just 15 years ago, and now is actually one of the most valuable companies in the world. It was competing against Microsoft, Dell, IBM, I'm talking about at the time, and actually has surpassed lots of the competitors and is now considered one of the most valuable companies on the planet. If we look at the element that made a real difference, we will discover that this element is culture, organizational culture. This explains the reason why organizational culture is key for a financially viable and successful company, and the reason why it's worth concentrating on cultural change if required in order to be more profitable. In the next few videos, I will be talking about in a very pragmatic and straightforward way, based on my 15 years experience and also of course on some solid theory, but I want to add the pragmatism, because with theory we don't go that far, do we, at the end of the day, and basically discuss what are the main aspects and elements of culture, what we have to focus on if we want to implement change. First, I would like to give you an additional free resource. If you click on the link down below this video in the description box, you can download completely for free a document that I have prepared with regards to how culture can be measured. It goes through some of the methodologies that your company can implement in order to measure culture. So let's start to debunk the myths relating to corporate culture and organizational culture. And most of all, let's start to be successful at managing organizational and cultural change. Thank you so much for watching.